Thank you for having invited me. So it's okay? Yeah? Oh yeah, yeah, so, yeah, yeah. And for having invited me, it is already late, so I shall try to keep it short and still provide some information to you. I am currently that activity in the Health Grain Project was in the past that you mentioned. I'm now coordinating the Health Bread Project. And that is a project, in fact, aiming at applying the results of the Big Health Grain Project and to get finally in the result that bakers, SME bakers, are producing healthy breads. It is a project of only 2 years, coordinated by TNO, with consortium partners VTT and TNO as research groups, 8 SME bakeries from 4 countries, 5 other SMEs, and 2 major flour producers who don't receive funding. And because I cannot so easily communicate with bakers in all European countries, we have installed a system of mentoring partners in Italy for Italian bakers, in Germany for German Austrian bakers, and in Netherlands a bakery research organization. So that helps me as coordinator that they can talk to the bakers and I don't have to do it all myself. It was already mentioned in earlier presentations that intake of dietary fiber is too low. What I would like to add is that if you look at recent dietary recommendations, like in Germany, they highlight the importance of cereal bran fibers as the best simply saying the best type of fiber there is. That is not the fiber that is used in this project where Vitacell, that was mentioned earlier in the presentation, that is a wheat fiber, but from the straw. So in fact, in my opinion, the naming it wheat fiber is misleading. You should call it cellulosic fiber because it doesn't contain all the co-passengers, minerals that normal wheat fiber contain. But okay, that is, I think maybe in the communication of the Chance project, I would advise that if you use that Vitacell fiber, it is a pure fiber, but don't say that it's a wheat fiber because that is misleading a lot of people. Yeah. Okay. We want to develop breads with also high fiber levels and also looking at an additional possible benefits like better bioavailability of the minerals. Andras showed already the wheat bran, the wheat kernel, and what we also are doing, we are using as one alternative the alurum, having high levels of fibers and minerals and not so much the color and the taste of normal bran. In fact, the most important is that you can have white bread, and by our treatments we hope to put it in the healthy area, and we even have possibilities to make whole grain bread healthier as well. We started, in fact, to the left you have the Health Grain Project. Then we have in the first year of the project, we studied dry processing, developing alurum fractions, other things, wet processing, like that long fermentation, bioprocessing, nutritional quality, baking quality in a central place, giving advices to the bakeries. They do the product development, and now they are doing consumer tests, and there is already one baker selling a product. This is in fact the principle we are applying. You use a base flour, you add one of the special wheat fractions, could be alurum, or you could select a very special wheat with light color, so that also has a mild taste. You can choose for bioprocessing it, long fermentation, 12-17 hours, with enzymes, and then you can bake it with bakery improvers, classic, with food enzymes, or with yeast only. So that is the options that the bakers have to decide in their situation. If you look at the dry processing, a very simple picture. If you want to get that high alurum, you have to remove the outer bran part, and then you are having a kind of alurum fraction that has additional health benefits. This is an interesting picture of results of that bioprocessing, that long fermentation of that wheat fraction. You see, if you have to do it in a normal way, by the phytase that is active from the wheat itself, you see a substantial decrease of your phytate. and that helps in making the iron and zinc bioavailable. And you can even increase that very much by adding some commercial phytase enzymes. And in the end, you end then with phytate levels as low as in white bread. So then you have, if you have the mineral levels of whole grain and only the phytate levels of white bread, you have really an increased bioavailability. This is a complicated picture, and you very simply, the upper black line on the in the graph, that is the volume of the white bread. The red line is the volume of a whole grain bread, and this is in between the volumes we are getting by using several fractions like soft wheat alurum, durum wheat alurum, wheat bran, or that special whole grain concentrate that with the light color. And you see indeed that by using enzymes and other things, you get improved volume, improved bread quality. This is what we are getting in nutritionally speaking, and we are also helping the bakers in communicating. So if you have over 6% fiber, you can call it high fiber. If you are over 15% of the recommended of the daily allowance of a mineral, you can call it source of that mineral. So here, one of our products, you see we are high in fiber, we are a source of iron, a source of magnesium, and a source of folate. And you can use it in your communication, you can use it for nutrition claims, you may also use health claims. If it is the high in fiber, you have improved laxation. And if it is, for instance, high in iron, magnesium, it reduces tiredness and fatigue. So you can also, we help the bakers even if they want to go for health claims. In fact, the difference with the Challenge Project, our bakers are aiming at the top end of the market by communicating we participated in the European project and we are now getting bread with the excellent taste resembling white bread and with much more health benefits. And we help them in giving the right message. And if you compare our project with the former Hellsgren project, we developed commercially viable processes for milling fractionation. And we optimized this by bioprocessing. And in the old Hellsgren project, bioprocessing, you got always low bread volume. Now we get high bread volume when possible. We get good bread quality. And we get bread produced by SME bakeries. I think that is also important. This is more or less how, and this is really a project where the partners will continue with producing products for the market. Like the Kampfmeyer Food Innovation Company, they have are using the knowledge gained with all the partners to find new and better opportunities for their special flours. The same is true for an Italian flour mill. They always sold their durum wheat alurum product for the animal feed. Now they have opportunity to have a better margin by selling it to bakeries and for healthier products. And the same is for a Geovita company in Italy, which does some special treatments with those raw materials. Also expands its market possibilities. Of the 8 SME bakeries, there is already one baker that is now selling 30 kilos a day of the product for a very good price after successful consumer tests. Other bakers in Austria and Germany are doing those tests and are definitely planning to launch products. And in the local newspapers, they get some nice reports. We are in a European project. There was 17 May an open day in Brussels where we participated. We were in that open day with a wood oven and thousands of consumers came along for our project. And some other producers are not so far as yet, but anyway, at least half of our SME bakers will definitely continue with this. And as a kind of final spin-off, We had one small enzyme producer, and they have decided, based on this project, an SME enzyme producer, to do major investment for entering the bakery market with enzymes produced. They were mostly in the biofuel market, they are now entering the bakery market, thanks to the project. Conclusion. By this combined technology development by flour millers, fermentation and others, and bakers, we got better wheat fractions, optimized enzymic modifications, attractive products, and it stimulates consumers to get higher intake of wheat grain and bioactive and fibers. And indeed, SME bakers can now add high quality breads to the range, and flour and ingredient suppliers, they have the know-how to have better and wider marketing of their special products to more SME bakers. And these are the partners of the project, and I would like to thank them for the work and you for your attention. Thank you.